Isn't it basically the same? Isn't it basically the same contraindications for soft and hard wax?
Yeah.
Open sores.
Open sores.
What else?
Mold. All
right. Are we putting on the gloves?
We wax.
Yeah. Do we apply the wax in what direction? The way the hair grows. Alright, done. Do not provide service without applying consultation in obtaining a fine
review. Sky.
Do not apply the wax without testing. Temperature. Do not apply the wax too thick. I went to the restroom the other day, someone had like, looked like they were putting frosting on the client's leg. What are you doing? Or put this in and use the soft wax. Do not double dip. Do not take their specimen and put it to the client and then go back and put their specimen back in their hand. You're going to have to. Do not let the soft wax cool before pulling it. It can bruise the skin. So when you're doing a bikini area, guys, y'all have to be very careful because there's that little bone right here that we have. You'll see that stopping point, and that's where you put stuff. So if you try to go from here to there all the way, you're going to get that fine, a big old bikini. So there's that stopping point. You always want to make sure you do that for the stopping point. Do not over wax the area. Second time in the service area. As it could burn this or otherwise damage the skin. Alright, so next to the right wax. That's about hard wax. So how many are going to wax? How many of you want to wax?
Crazy.
Adhere to the skin, therefore it causes less irritation. It's effective where the hair grows in multiple directions. This is all hard wax then. Prefer to use in the baby area during the vaginium. This area can be waxed second time during the services to provide no irritation. So hard wax is good for the baby area. It's also good for coarse, very coarse hair on the chin, the upper lip, eyebrows can be waxed typically. Eyebrows may be waxed in topical prescription if used, but not applied to direct area. No, that is wrong. If there is a topical, if they're using a topical medication, do not wax that client. Literally do not. If you feel like you're having second hesitation to say no, it's not. You're taking a topical medication. It's just best once you get off of it, come back in 4 weeks, and then we can do the wax service. Because you can lift that client's skin. If they had a chemical
supposed to watch the video on the waxing and do the steps and submit the video. So if we're online, if you, I think it said like arms and legs. So I just have a mannequin. What do you want me to do?
You can do the step, right the step.
And just submit the steps.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Instructions also. What are the first?
Blackheads in the underarms or ingrown hairs?
Yeah. It's black.
Okay, so there is
really
ingrown hair.
You come out here because you have it set up.
So, you know, it's very large. It's like, it's like a very big holes in it. So I don't know.
Okay, so you need to make sure what it is first.
It looks like it's
I think they're ingrown hairs, what you're looking at. You need to literally take a magnifying lamp and look at it closely. If it's ingrown hairs,
Can we finish? Yes.
If it's ingrown hairs, you need to go ahead and get an extraction tool, and you're going to have to push on it. You have to go literally around it to help it come out. You can get tweezers and try to pull it out, but you have to be very careful because again, you're going to have to be sanitized and make sure you have adequate care because if you cause any damage, it can get infected and it can be worse. So if it gets to the point where the client has pus and it's hot and it's got like pink pus, you're going to be directed to a physician. But again, that is happening because either exfoliating, they're not moisturizing, or when they're applying the wax and they're removing wrong. That's what I'm calling the ingrown hairs.
Okay. And if it's blackheads, what?
I can't comprehend how blackheads get underneath the underarm.
Can I send you a picture?
Yes, ma'am. Send me a picture.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Randy, I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm on phase 4, week 1, I guess. And it, like, on the homework or underneath the phase 4, week 1 tab, it has job applications, online application for employment, like, what you're, you want me to apply for jobs and send that to you, or?
Yeah, cause I need to, guys, because I don't know,
I mean, I've been looking on Indeed, like, in my area, there's really not any jobs for estheticians or anything right now, so I'll look, but if I can't find anything, then, I mean, I can attach my resume, I do have that.
Okay, so you need to do your resume, you need to at least give me 3 to 4 jobs that you can apply to. Why are you going to apply to that company? What are the benefits? If they can give you, if they have an amount listed, and the mock interview, y'all need questions? I have a whole question that y'all can ask, or y'all can answer, and then y'all can always ask the company.
Okay, thank you.
I have a question. Where is the video? What will the video be under for the double cleanse video and the fits scale? I'm kind of, I emailed you. So
okay. Like I said, guys, if you listen to me, I teach from 9 to 9. I literally have like 30 minutes to an hour lunch. And I'm, like yesterday, I tried to do emails yesterday and I got full and I had to do a one-on-one. And so I know how to critique and I did try to grade for that past.
Fitzpatrick.
Okay, Fitzpatrick. So you're going to go on the side and look for form. You go to form and you see Fitzpatrick's type chart and you're going to answer this question.
Okay, thank you.
So, and then you see all the little points right here. So you add up all the points and then gives you your skin, your Fitzpatrick skin type.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Randy, what about where it says, state board written exam. What are we supposed to do on that?
State board written exam. Have you, from what my knowledge, I am Brayden. Brayden says that it lives on 10 days, but if it doesn't, let me know so I can get the 250 questions from Brayden and send it to you.
You're like, oh. Let me see. Would it be under state board materials, maybe?
There's not a test there, but we can go look.
Because I think that only has, like, the candidate bulletin, practical. I don't see a written exam in that.
Yeah, I don't see a written exam. That's what they bring it, says he has one physically. So, you can do the one at Cengage and see if they have one. But it's not like it's focusing on questions. So, I'm going to talk to him today and see if I can create one for...
I know that Cengage doesn't have one. We have, like, a test after each chapter, but I don't think that there's, like, one big test at the end, or I haven't seen it anyway.
Okay. Let me know that I'll get the one from Brayden and have you take it.
Okay. Can you go ahead and do that? Because I'm pretty sure I haven't seen that in Cengage.
Okay. I'll email now and then email it to you.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Anybody else?
Can I get that
struggling.